could you tell me, Dad, what was the secondary school that you went to?
Yeah, West Hill Boys School.
How old were you when you left?
11. Oh, 14.
14?
Yeah.
And what did you do then? What was your first career path at that point?
I went as a 7-year indentured apprentice engineer at a local engineering factory.
What was the name of the company?
Wainwright, Thomas Wainwright and Sons.
And what did they make?
They did a lot for the mill industry. It's all to do with the engineering qualities of getting the power from the engine house to the factory. And they used to have to go to these different mills and maintain them. We used to go out there and make parts and then go back and fit them.
Is that the mills for the cotton industry?
Yeah, for the cotton, yeah. They had a lot of trade. They did other things as well, but they were what they call millwrights, you see. They were millwright engineers. Their main business was looking after the big steam engines, what provided the power to the mills.
What skills did you learn when you were doing that apprenticeship? What sorts of things?
Well, you did general engineering practices. You went in as an apprentice. I got pretty good at it reasonably, but I wasn't too liked at that place to the end of when I got to the age of about 16, because I complained to the union that they weren't treating the apprentices right. And they sent a union representative down to the factory, and it caused a bit of a confrontation.
Sister, what did you, were you not happy about with the factory then?
The young ones in particular, like the first ones who start, you used to have to do all kinds of horrible jobs. On a Friday night, you used to have to take the union money down to the union offices, because they were always doing overtime. So they had the youngest apprentices that were not just me, the younger ones in the factory who just started. You used to have to collect the money on a Friday and mark all the cards, the union cards, and tot all the money up, and then take it to the union offices on a Friday night, and then give them back on Monday mornings. And I didn't think we should do all that kind of thing. And they give you horrible jobs like cleaning out the boilers for the heating system. You should be like going into a submarine, because you were little and small. And the hole was only about so wide. You had to drop down, sit on the fire tubes with a little metal hammer and chip all the corrosion off the tubes. I mean, you're talking about the length of a house. I mean, not these boilers. You know, you're in there for days and days with a lamp. It's just like being in prison. And I didn't think it was right.
And you were only like 15 or so when you...
14 then, 14.
Yeah.
14 years of age. So I complained about all this and they stopped it, the union. They actually stopped it. And then a chap came in the factory as a new man called Bob. I don't know his other name. And I got quite friendly with him. And he said, "Well, you want to get out of this job?" He said, "Why are you young? Get out." He said, "Look at me. I've been here all my life doing this flipping job, tied down to it." He said, "If you can get out, get out." I used to go to the night. Well, we went to night schools 3 nights a week in the winter, learning all about engineering. I kind of liked it, the actual machining part of it, but we didn't get enough of it. They put you on repetition jobs and doing the same thing over and over again, you know. They put me in a room on a milling machine doing slots for, it was to do with the war effort, and there was hundreds of them, all on my own, shut off from the rest of the factory. And it was boring, you know, doing the same thing. And I didn't think we should be doing that. I thought we should be more learning about the actual way engineering worked, like you did at night school. At night school, we got proper training going on there, and I could see what we were doing in high school wasn't being replicated during the day in the factory. But why did I go into engineering in the first place instead of what my dad wanted me to do? He wanted me to go into joinery as a coffin apprentice, making coffins.
Yeah.
And it was a good job. But it was because of the headmaster, Mr. Fletcher, who was the headmaster of Westdale Boys School, that he advised me. He said, I think it'd be better to go into engineering, because they used to get the different firms. They used to know what jobs were coming available for the people who are leaving school as an headmaster.
Uh-huh.
So he advised me to take the Wainwright job, and that's what I did. You know.
Did you complete the apprenticeship though?
No, I left when I was 17 and a half.
You say milling, was that like doing the milling machines and the turning machines and that?
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Shaping machine, milling machine, boring machine. I was on a lathe about 8 foot diameter lathe doing these bits. I used to enjoy that. That was okay again.
So you said something else actually made or pushed you to decide to leave.
That was the main thing. Harold Bird, who was in the same class as me at Westhill School, we were both studying engineering. He was in a different factory altogether than me. But we all used to go to night school, and we used to meet at night school. So those apprentices who were interested could do a one night a week course in the summer as well. And it was on at this point in the summer, we were on this course, and Harold used to come he was there in the same class as me. We'd be on the machines of fitting and filing and all this kind of thing. And then he didn't turn up one week, and the following week he came, and I said, what happened to you last week, Harold? Oh, I said, I had a date. I scummed off, he said. I went to the pictures with my girlfriend. I said, oh, yeah, confused, you know. Sorry. He said, you know when they put the adverts on the film, on the screen before the actual main film starts? I said, yeah. He said, well, there was an advert there for the 10th Royal Hussars Military Band. We had to contact this man, John Hopwood. We went to see this John Hopwood, and he told us what would happen if we joined. When Harold and I joined, we volunteered, because you couldn't get into what you wanted to do if you were conscripted. You were put where they sent you. The only way you could do what you wanted to do was to volunteer. So Harold and I, we volunteered at that point to get into the military band. So we did that on the assumption that we'd get a training in the forces. But it didn't explain to us that at that point, it was just after the war, and the bands were undersubscribed. Actually, I should have took my father's advice and took the joinery, but then I might never have gone into music. Before, we used to buy tools as well. My dad used to get these tools, chisels and grind them up and make them sharp, ready for me doing this job. And he was quite surprised when I actually went into the engineering. And I've still got some of those tools now. He was now in my toolbox. There's tools there which I had for me to go into joining, which I never used. It was because I wasn't happy, really, at the engineering, and Harold seeing this advert, that, convinced me to move out of it, you know. I mean, it's a big thing to give up there, to give up apprenticeship, you know. Mm-hmm. I mean, Dad said, you've got to make your own mind up, he said. And that's why when I got into the forces and finally got into the band, I decided, well, I've got to do this now, otherwise I'm going to end up doing nothing. I've got to make a go of this, and I used to practice like mad, you know. Mm-hmm. To get to a reasonable standard, you know.